time again for Talking Dogs with Ian Grant, dog trainer at Vermont Dog Boarding and Behavior, VFW Drive in Hyde Park. It's the show that delves into the training, socializing, behavior, and nutrition of your dog. And brought to you by Guy's Farm and Yard with locations in Morrisville, Montpelier, Williston, and St. Albans. And we're back with the trainer, Ian Grant, and today we're talking about dog patterns. So this is not specifically for people who crochet. That's not the not kind of patterns we're talking about. We're talking about patterns that dogs may develop, good or bad. So where do we start with our patterns today?
Well, I think we always talk about how dogs are, you know, creatures of habit, and they're in their routine. And this isn't going to be so much of a subject on that as it is, what are your dog's patterns of behavior? What do they do maybe when somebody comes over? What do they do if they hear something outside? What do they do on the walk? And to me, the most important thing to do is to recognize these patterns first. Once you see a pattern, then you have the ability to work ahead of it. Meaning if you have, you know, a dog that tends to react at the front door when people come over, well, we get ahead of that by putting the dog on leash and invite somebody over, and then we get to work on it, you know, and it gives us access to be able to work with the dog. Really, we want to get in between the ears. We already know what makes our dog tick, but if we can get in there and teach them something different, because teaching them also drains energy, then we have the ability to work on that certain behavior. We always say that, you know, we work on teachable moments, you know, when guests come over. You can certainly do that. There's nothing wrong with it. And that's kind of just being in a reactive state of mind. But once you recognize your dog's patterns, then you have the ability to be proactive. You get ahead of the behavior, meaning you start working with your dog before that bad behavior starts.
So it's important to keep track of these patterns, good or bad, just so that you have them in the back of your mind. So if they need to be rectified, that you know what to rectify. So it's important to keep track of these things, not just blow them off, you know?
Yeah, you know, let's say your dog gets really excited when they hear food hit the dish, you know, and it's feeding time or somewhere around that time or that type of ritual. Then, you know, again, it might be some leash work, and we slowly work the dog through. Maybe somebody else in your house can get the food ready while you're working with your dog on leash, maybe just to keep it in a simple sit position right next to you. We're breaking that routine because what had been previously happening isn't working for us. Who wants their dog to be crawling all over them while they're trying to get their food ready? You know, we want some respect and some space. So, you know, recognize these patterns can be difficult to start with, but once you start to kind of keep track of it and you'll learn, things start to click. You'll see it, you know, once you recognize it, then you have the ability to change it.
And breaking the pattern isn't just something that you can do overnight. It's something that you do over a course of time. And then I guess that gets back to when you're training your dog, you got to be consistent. I guess breaking a pattern is the same thing.
It's the exact same thing. You know, again, if that dog is super excited for mealtime, I mean, that's, you know, and you're feeding twice a day, that's over 700 times a year your dog gets to practice that. Your one session is not going to break those 700 times that it's been, you know, become routine to your dog. So you have to put in that time. We can't do it one time and think, okay, we just handled breakfast, so dinner tonight will be no problem whatsoever. There has to be some reinforcement there and be able to be consistent with your dog and show them that structure and the boundary of what you want, what you've created.
Yeah. Consistency is always the thing.
It always is.
Most important thing.
Even if the consistency is negative, at least the dog knows what to expect from us.
Right. So, and you have to let the dog know that it's a pattern that needs to be broken too.
Exactly. And that's being a part of getting ahead of it and then working on it and then reinforcing it. And then you can create a new pattern, one that you actually want.
All right. Back with our question from the doggy bag coming up in just a moment here on Talking Dogs. Back with Talking Dogs with Ian Grant. If you've got a question for the trainer, email him with your question. That's ian@vtdogbnb.com. Also, visit his website to find out more about the programs that are available at Vermont Dog Boarding and Behavior. Go to vermontdogtrainer.com. Our question this morning, Ian, is why does my dog bark at people when they leave my house? Bye. See you later.
Right.
Don't come back. Why do they bark when they leave? I would think it'd be more like they bark when they're coming in the door.
I know, and most people will expect that to a degree, right? My dog barks when my
when they come in, when they hear something. But yeah, so why would they bark when you're leaving?
There's a number of different reasons, and I could rattle them all off. But obviously, this is a very generic question because some dogs will bark and actually chase after people's heels and try to nip and bite and do that. Other dogs will sit back and bark because a lot of times, if you think about it from the dog's point of view, let's say you're sitting around with your family. There's four of you in the family. You've got two guests over. Everybody's sitting down, talking, having a good time. It's time to leave. All six people get up. They start moving. There's a change in the energy in the house. Like, everything is changing. Everybody's moving at the same time. To your dog, that gets your dog's attention. Like, what's going on here? You know, and then you get people putting on coats. And even though to us it may not be full of energy and a lot of excitement, to your dog, man, why is everybody moving? My whole pack is moving. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing. Part of the pack that was, you know, spent the last few hours here is leaving. I don't understand that. So if you look at it from their perspective, it's kind of confusing. You know, from our perspective, it's 100% natural for people to come visit us, hang out, and then leave as well.
Is that a common problem? Because the dogs that I've had over my years, I never experienced that. I find it kind of unusual that actually they'd be barking, you know, as you're leaving. Usually they just, bye.
Yeah, I think it's more common than what we think. This is probably a question I get maybe a couple of times a month with different scenarios and different intensities, too. Like I said, some dogs are nipping and biting at ankles as people are walking out. You know, other dogs are just sitting back barking, kind of in some frustration and some confusion. So without video, it's hard to picture what's happening here. But it can be a problem, but it also can be worked on, too.
All right. So I have a suggestion. To break the pattern?
Yes.
Just have everybody who comes in, never let them leave.
Yes, exactly.
Just build onto the house.
Exactly. And this is definitely one of those patterns, too, right?
Yeah, that we were talking about. Yeah. Yep. So, break it. Yeah, you have to think about that. So.
Just keep adding on to your house and adding on and adding on.
Okay, we're glad to have you here. You're not leaving.
Yes.
All right. Have a question for Ian again. You can email him, ian@vtdogbnb.com. Next week, it's Twinkie time, Thanksgiving. That's nice for us, but for your dogs, you got to be careful on giving them the leftovers because it's not really good for them, really.
No, and we'll certainly dive into the nutritional aspect of everything here, as we always like to talk about. And it may not be as obvious as don't give your dog chocolate like during the Halloween time. So, yeah we got to be careful.
Yeah, because some of that, some of the turkey innards and all can be a bit bad for stomachs.
Mm-hmm.
So, we'll talk about that next week on Talking Dogs with Ian Grant and brought to you by Guy's Farm and Yard, with locations in Morrisville, Montpelier, Williston, and St. Albans. And for the trainer Ian Grant, I'm Roland LaJoy, and we are Talking Dogs.